So the definition for recorded by says a list, contaminated and separated, of names of people, groups, or organizations responsible for recording the original occurrence. The primary collector or observer, especially one who applies a personal identifier, which is known in Brahma Corps as a record number, should be listed first. So the collector in Dharma Corps goes under the field recorded by. Now, I'm giving you the hint for the next one. What should number go under? In the database, it's fairly vague. It's just a number. But it's associated with the collector. At least it appears to be. So what field of Dharma Corps should the collector number go into? Same winner twice. We have a Dharma Corps expert, officially. Yes. Okay, here's an easy one. You're all winners on this one. What field in Dharma Corps should the family go into? You can do it. Just tell me. Taxon term, look at the list of taxon terms.
77.
Somebody said it?
Yeah.
Robert? Family. Family goes in the family field. Finally, we have something where the name in the database is exactly the same as the name in our own car. You can see, however, that it's not very common. So, in mapping data sets to Dharma Corps, it's essential to actually understand what the Dharma Corps consists of. So the next one is species. If we look at the content of it, it looks kind of like a scientific name with some extra stuff in it. Okay? It looks like a genus plus a specific epithet plus a designator saying that there is some subspecies, but we don't know what it is. So this is a little bit of a complicated situation in Dharma Corps. Why is that? Because a scientific name is supposed to be a scientific name. And if you put a subspecies at the end of a scientific name, it no longer is a scientific name. Right? You can't look in a list of names and find it as a SUBSP3. So this field called species in the database is more than just a scientific name. We're going to help you out with this one. This one is a combination of many different fields in Dharma Corps. But we have to pull the data apart to fill in the Dharma Corps. So we go back and look at the after. This consists of the scientific name. The scientific name part is everything up to the subspot. So scientific name is one of the fields that you can go into. The subspot has to go somewhere else. If you remember the question earlier this morning about, okay, what if I identify a specimen and I don't know exactly what it is? This is exactly the case. Right? So if you remember what I said in answer to that question, there's a field called identification qualifier where you can put that extra information. This one. So That's the one that says CFP or AFP or something. What we want to do is to put the part of that species field into identification qualifier that is not actually the scientific name. So back to the spreadsheet. There's more than one field here. And the value then for the Darwin core value should be subscript. Now you can see we had to do some data cleaning to pull that off. Right? We had to tear apart the original, figure out what was the scientific name, what wasn't the scientific name, and put the rest in a different field altogether. Well, we're going to do that still further.
I think there's more information in the species field. It's not any subspecies, but some other words.
Is there more?
I think so. So if you can expand that can become B.
There is. Okay. So we actually do know the subspecies. We take back what we just said about identification qualifier. But we still have to tear apart that scientific name because the subspy in there is not legal in a scientific name. It's telling us that the species is further identified to an infraspecific name. Okay? In this case, it's Bohili, but it's also a subspecies as opposed to a variety. So we have two more pieces of information going on. So if we get rid of identification qualifier, which is no longer necessary, and instead add, we have to change our scientific name also. The subspecies epithet. So that was it. Actually, botanist in the room, is it a valid scientific name to have the subspecies in there between the specific epithet and the interspecific epithet? Is that a valid scientific name in the database value?
No.
No.
Well, in put like that, then it's not valid. Except it's a subspecies, you don't have to put the subspecies.
So is the original correct?
Yeah, the original is correct.
The original is correct as a scientific name?
Yes.
Okay.
So
background. Thank you. Scientific name is there and the date is correct. Okay. Now, there's more information that we can pull out of that name for Darwin core purposes. We could just do that and leave it as it is, but I want to show you the other mappings that can be done as well. So if you create maybe two or three more. We have a scientific name. It consists of a genus, a specific epithet, an infraspecific rank, and an infraspecific epithet. There are actually four parts to that name that we can pull apart and put into separate Darwin core fields, all of which exist. Genus, and below that, specific epithet, and below that, taxon rank, and below that, infraspecific epithet. So all of that we can get out of one field in the original. I'll leave So if you looked at the index of fields in Darwin core, you can see all of those in zero. So if you look at their descriptions, You can see that they're meant to be the parts of the scientific name. And so it should be possible in Darwin Court to actually pull this thing apart into its components, as well as to provide it in its full form. Thank you for the help on the scientific name thing. I'm not seeing it. Okay, does that make sense? This is to point out that there may be more than one field as a destination for the information in the original. If you want to try to complete. We move on to the next field then. So now if we look at the collected field, how many different fields could this go into in the Darwin plot? Many, many different fields. But in the form that it's in right now, what is the most appropriate single field in Darwin plot to put that information into? Yeah? Event date. Okay? Event date, so your guess is with the event date. So, it says here that it's recommended that it go into event date in this ISO 8601 format, which requires that there be a year followed by a dash, followed by two digits, followed by a dash, followed by two digits. And that's not exactly what we have. Now, we should be able to produce this form in the original, but that's not the form that we have exactly. So if you want to keep the original form, where do we put that? Just exactly as it was written, where would we put that? You see how it's not 1961-11-07. That's what we're calling it. That information has a place in Darwin Plot. Event date is the right idea, but there's another field. Anyone remember where it is? You're right. We can also split it apart. But I'm posing the hypothesis that there is, in fact, a single field in which that value can go directly also. And I want to capture that. Verbatim event date, yes. That takes the date in whatever form it comes in, even if it's fully represented date. So let's do that first. Put the value in event date, verbatim event date, yeah, thank you. Exactly as it was on the left. And now we'll go with the other suggestions. The other places that we can put it are into event date. If we transform it, we change its format to look like this. And then there was a suggestion that you go into other fields as well. What other fields were those? Look in the event section of Darwin Court, should have all the date and time fields. So we have start day of year, end day of year. Can we fill those in from a date? We can actually. We have to know the formula and how to deal with leap years and things like that. But we can actually calculate the start day of year and the end day of year from that verbatim date. So we won't actually do the calculation, I won't make Kyle do that, but we know that we can fill in those fields. And then we also have the year, month, and day separated into their own fields, which we can also fill in. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fields in Darwin Core from one single field in the original database. Everyone see how we can do that? Except for what the calculation is to make the start and end data here. Can you go ahead and add a row for end data here?